Hi friends, welcome to our channel Knowledge Train. Today also we are discussing some questions related to FSSAI exam. Let's begin. Silicates are used in food as. The answer is anti-caking agents. Option C, anti-caking agents. What do you mean by an anti-caking agent? Anti-caking agent is an additive placed in powdered or granulated materials such as table salt or confectionaries to prevent the formation of lumps or cake forming and for easing packaging, transport, flowability and consumption. Anti-caking agents are additives which are added to some powdered or granulated materials in order to avoid lump formation or caking. And some of the examples of anti-caking agents are, that is silicates, the form of silicates mainly used is potassium silicate and sodium silicate. Actually, this potassium and sodium silicate is used as industrial cleaners and detergents. And which form of silicate is used in food? It is sodium metasilicate. The sodium metasilicate, it is a grass that is generally recognized as safe, generally regarded as safe. It is grass status. This sodium metasilicate is a additive which has grass status. It is an anti-caking agent which is added in materials to prevent lump formation or cake formation. And here, thickeners. What do you mean by thickeners? Thickeners or thickening agent, it is a substance which can increase the viscosity of a liquid without substantially changing its other properties. Thickeners are also additives added to the material to improve the or increase the viscosity of that substance without changing other properties of that substance. Next is emulsifying agents. Emulsifying agents stabilizes an emulsion. Best example of an emulsifying agent which is present in egg yolk is lecithin. Lecithin is an emulsifying agent present in egg yolk. And it is used to, or emulsifying agents are added to food to stabilize that process to food. It is the role of emulsifying agents as an additive. Next is chelating agents. What is the role of chelating agent in food? Chelating or sequestering. These agents protect the food products from many enzymatic reactions that promote deterioration during processing and storage. Next question. Which of the following food sources may contain probiotics? Which of the following food sources may contain probiotics? The answer is option D, yogurt. Answer is option D, yogurt. Yogurt which contains probiotics. What are these probiotics? Actually, probiotics are live bacteria and yeast that are good for human health. Especially, the probiotic is needed by our digestive system. These probiotics are often called as good or helpful bacteria because they help keep your gut healthy. The main probiotic bacteria is the lactobacillus. The main probiotic bacteria is the lactobacillus. And it is found in yogurts and other fermented food products. And there is which is similar to the probiotics, that is prebiotics. Actually, this prebiotic is a non-digestible food ingredient that promotes the growth of beneficial microorganisms in the intestines. It is a non-digestible food ingredient that promotes the growth of beneficial microorganisms in the intestine. Probiotics are beneficial microorganisms which is found in the intestines, and prebiotics are non-digestible food substances that help the beneficial microorganisms to grow. The examples of prebiotics are prebiotic fiber, which is present in bananas, onions, and garlics. This prebiotic fibers goes through the small intestine undigested, and this substance is fermented when it reaches the large colon. And this is about prebiotics. Next question. Milk that can remain on supermarket shelves free of microbial growth for many years has been processed by which of the following methods? The milk that can remain on supermarket shelves free of microbial growth for many years has been processed by which of the following methods? The answer here is aseptic processing. Option A, aseptic processing. The aseptic milk processing takes place before the packaging with very short heating and cooling times. Aseptic processing, which means the sterilization of the food materials before with it is packing, and it is packed into a sterile container in a sterile environment. That is meant by aseptic processing. And here for the milk is heated to about 275 to 300 degree Fahrenheit for 2 to 15 seconds. And once the milk is cooled, then it is packed to a special tetra pack aseptic container for more year storaging. This milk is packed in a tetra pack aseptic container and sealing in natural goodness of milk for many months. By this aseptic processing, that is steriling the milk, then it is packed into an aseptic container, which is a tetra pack container. In this way, we can store the milk for many years or for many months. And here is the answer slide. And next question. pH of packaged drinking water shall be between. The pH of packaged drinking water shall be between. The answer is 6.5 to 8.5. The answer is 6.5 to 8.5. The pH of packaged drinking water is 6.5 to 8.5. Next question. What is an example of biological hazard? What is an example of biological hazard? Here the answer is option A, Salmonella. Salmonella is a biological hazard. What is a biological hazard? It is a hazard related to food safety in conditions or contaminants that cause illness or injury. A biological hazard is a hazard related to food safety. That hazard may occur in conditions or as contaminants that cause illness or injury. Actually, these biological hazards include microorganisms such as bacteria, viruses, yeast, mold or parasites, etc. And here, Salmonella infection, that is salmonellosis. It is a common bacterial disease that affects the intestinal tract. And actually, this Salmonella is caused by eating raw or uncooked food, especially the meat, poultry, eggs or egg product. Salmonella is caused by consuming raw or undercooked meat, poultry, egg or egg products. Next question. SPS under WTO stands for. SPS under WTO stands for. The answer is sanitary and phytosanitary measures. SPS means sanitary and phytosanitary measures. ISO 19011-2011 quality management system deals with. ISO 19011-2011 quality management deals with The answer is option D, guidelines for quality and or environmental management systems auditing. ISO 19011-2011 quality management system deals with the guidelines for quality and or environmental management system auditing. Next question. Sugar and salt act as preservatives by. Sugar and salt act as preservatives by. The answer here is option D, binding water, so it is not available for microorganisms. Binding with water, so it is not available for microorganism. Sugar and salt is used as preservatives. Here the salt, sodium chloride will change the osmotic pressure. Both the sugar and the salt change the osmotic pressure of the environment. And thus the available water will be less. So the chances of bacterial spoilage or the water available for the bacteria will be less, so the chances of bacterial spoilage will be less. Thus the sugar and salt act as preservatives. Next question. Which of the following is or are true about potassium bromate? Which of the following is or are true about potassium bromate? The answer is option B, 1 and 2, which means potassium bromate is a category 2B carcinogen. And also, potassium bromate increases dough strength, leads to higher rising and uniform finish to baked products. Potassium bromate is a category 2B carcinogen, and potassium bromate increases this dough strength, leads to higher rising and uniform finish to baked products. Actually, these food additives are banned in many countries, including India, because of the hazardous nature of this product, this additive to public health. Next question. How many scientific panels have been constituted in the Food Authority? How many scientific panels have been constituted in the Food Authority? The answer is option A, 16. There are 16 scientific panels constituted in the Food Authority. Next question. Which of these is not an international standards and statutes? Which of these is not an international standards and statutes? From the option, it is very clear that the answer is option D, Bureau of Indian Standards. Bureau of Indian Standards, it is a national organization. The rest all other, that is the CODAS, the FAO and the European Union standards are all international standards and statutes. Next question. Bacterial contamination may cause food poisoning. The conditions required for bacterial growth are: the bacterial contamination may cause food poisoning, and the conditions required for bacterial growth are, the answer is option C, moisture, warm temperature, time, food supply, low acid environment and oxygen. These are all the conditions which is required for bacterial growth. Next question. In food safety and standards, that is for food product standards and food additive regulations 2011, the antibacterial polypeptide, which is permitted as a preservative in cheese and cheese products, is. The antibacterial polypeptide, which is permitted as preservative in cheese and cheese product by the Food Safety and Standards Regulation 2011, is option B, niacin. Niacin is a bactericidal agent which is added in cheese and cheese products. Next question. Enzymes which are mainly used in clarification of fruit juices are pectinases and pectin esterases. These are the enzymes which are mainly used in clarification of fruit juices. And thank you for listening this video. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Please subscribe our channel, press the notification button and share with your friends.